but they making a mockery following us. This ain't monopoly, watching for love. This ain't monogamy, y'all getting fucking. Jumping on what the hell is that? I gotta relax when I feel.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the great state of Tennessee at Nissan Stadium here in Nashville. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Chicago Bears and the Tennessee Titans. Charles and I have been looking forward to this one all week, and off we go from Nashville. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. They'll start with the option. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That's a good way to start the drive. 17 yards and a first down. That may be a sneak peek on this opening drive of what this young rookie can showcase, his legs.
And normally, as you start a game, you're just thinking, can he get the snap? Can he hand off? Can he just execute? Instead, he doesn't waste any time on wrapping another dimension to his game, showing off those wheels and picking up some nice yardage.
That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and that'll make it second down. On the ground, this is Derrick Henry. And he's got it across midfield and into Bear territory. Call it a gain of 3, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be third and about a foot or two. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
They'll run. It's Henry. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. They're able to keep the drive alive 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one.
Well, that's what's called being aggressive right there, but I don't know that it's reckless. I think it's much more of a message, hey, defense, I believe in you in case we don't get it. And offense, trying to let him know he believes in him as well.
I like it. And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. Touchdown, Titans. Austin Hooper, 43 yards. And the Titans will jump on top of the game's first score here this afternoon. Bullock good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now Bullock will send this one away after the touchdown. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Now it's Fields off the bootleg. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Bud Dupree. And the Titans are going to take possession of the football. So already trailing, Charles, they opted to try to take a shot on their first play from scrimmage. Obviously, that one didn't pan out.
Absolutely not. And how about the momentum that's being created now? You score, you take it away, big return. You've got a chance to go up 2 touchdown.
Malik Willis connecting with Traylon Burks for the score. And the Titans are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Now Bullock to add the extra point. And it's good. And they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. Bullock will send this one away after the touchdown. no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Charles, it's kind of gut check time. Look, I know it's early first quarter, just their second drive of the game, but they've already thrown the interception, given up the score. You're down double digits. They got to figure out something and pretty quickly here.
No doubt about it. And when we look at that sideline, I'm sure you're observing the same thing I am. I don't like the body language at all. They look like they're in a state of stunned disbelief. So to me, we always talk about someone stepping up and making a big play. I think it would behoove them if multiple guys step up and make big plays right now. They need something positive to happen, and they need for it to happen now.
Off play action, Fields. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Now nowhere for Fields to turn, and down he goes. So now following the sack, Fields and the Bears looking at third down and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And firing a deep ball for Kmet. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
Two things you can do in that situation. Run and punt the football and try and take your shot at getting the first down. They chose the latter, but they'll have to punt all the same.
Wait, no, so. No point in that punt.
They snap it to Fields. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Titans, they've got the football back and they've got it in great field position. First down carry for Henry. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Oftentimes, when you see a running back get bunched up in the backfield, it's usually because the defensive tackle is eating up blockers for others to make the play.
All right.
Not in this case.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Here's Willis. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they're going to get this down inside the 20. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of four. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. Third down, it's Willis. Can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. It'll go as a sack, a loss of three, and in turn, it takes us to a fourth down. Bullock's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So the starting field position was terrific following the surprising turnover on downs, but the end result, only 3 points.
Simply stated, I think you have to look at that as a missed opportunity.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. See if they can do better here on this drive. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Well, this defense is certainly organized and playing off of each other because the rush is providing pressure and the coverage is forcing incompletions and capitalizing on mistakes. When you get every level on defense hitting at once, you get first half score.
All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Amari Hooker, and the Titans are going to take possession of the football. Boy, we've seen a lot of mistakes here in this first half, and another there on the interception.
Yeah, they're certainly starting to pile up, aren't they? Because, let's face it, we expect a miscue here and there, but they're already down three scores and still giving the ball away. If they want to get back into this one, they've got to take care of the ball, because right now the way they're playing doesn't say a whole lot for their chances.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
That was nice work there defensively to force incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
On second down, here's Henry. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
And it's caught by Hooker.
What are you doing?
The Titans' first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick it down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
And Henry gets the call there on first down as he pushes his way forward. A pickup of about 5.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they're coming.
That's a pick! Oh!
And they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Here's first and goal, and gosh, points here. A chance maybe to put this thing away before halftime. Now Willis to throw. And it's a Titans touchdown. Derrick Henry from 6 yards away. And the Titans continue to pull away here in this first half. Extra point and good by Bullock. And a wrap is on here in this first half. Send this one away after the touchdown. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. Well, CD, you kind of feel like they're in a bit of a danger zone right here, because now you're down 3 scores, and I know we're in the first half, but the way this offense hasn't been able to generate anything, you feel like they probably need to get something going on this drive, right?
Yeah, and sometimes I overuse that this is an important possession, but I think this has to be the possession where they come up with an answer, because only a few teams in league history ever come back from a 4-score deficit, and if they don't score here, that's what they could be facing the next time they get the ball.
Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. That's over 40 yards of movement with those last 2 plays.
Now that's the kind of big play you'd like to see. This first half, it hasn't gone their way, and they could use a shot in the arm, something to perk them up a bit. And they get one here in the passing game.
Again, Fields. This is caught. Touchdown, Bears! Justin Fields finding Darnell Mooney, and the Bears are able to cut into that deficit. Down three scores already. This game was really in danger of getting away from them. They needed a drive like that, especially on the road.
Not only to calm themselves, but maybe tamp down the crowd a little bit, because everything was against them. As you noted, this game could have gotten away from them very easily, but instead, the calming drive, now they have a little bit more confidence. Okay, we're back in it. All right, we're ready to go. That was impressive.
And the defense now needs to reciprocate. He hits the big target for the two-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And still plenty of time remaining here in the half, more than a minute. We'll see if they just want to protect that lead or try to add on to it.
Well, with as much time as is left on the clock, I would imagine it would be the latter. I think they're going to try and add on to it. So what they're going to tell the team is very simple.
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. And they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown. Boy, a big play right there. I mean, a touchdown on this drive could have really put some separation on the scoreboard. Instead, it's the defense who scores. And, partner, we got a game again.
And we do have one because of what you just described, a defense that understood what was going on in this game and did something about it. They knew their offense needed some help. They just provided it. They're back in this one.
Fields trying to throw for it. Rolling to his left. And he is in for the 2 points, and they're back within a score as the lead's cut to 8. So two successful two-point tries now for them.
And you know what it does? It gives you a boost, a huge one for your team, because, hey, you're dominating them now. They can't stop you either scoring touchdowns or two-point conversions. But how about the defense? You don't know what to do at this stage. You can't stop them in any direction.
Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And just inside of a minute left, Charles. They got a pretty long field ahead of them. I'm curious to see how they play this, but you would think definitely enough time to at least try to get 3 out of this.
Yeah, you want to move with a nice sense of pace. You want to up the tempo a little bit, but you have to do it with some poise as well. You don't want to go so fast that you hurry yourself into mistakes. There's enough time to put points on the board if they do it right.
And even though they have the lead, you know that they would love to extend this lead. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it, and the Bears are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half, and you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it, his teammates going to check on it, because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because 2 interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. He'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down. A play fake, now Fields to throw. That's complete to his running back, Herbert. He's got room at the 30. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. That good for 21 yards on the catch and run.
A lot of times the key is just get him the ball and let him do his thing. And they got it out to him on the left side, and he did exactly that. Excellent run after the catch.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Fields. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now just under 30 seconds to go in this first half.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try to pick up another first down.
To the air again, Fields. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half.
They made a nice effort to stick it with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
Now it's Fields. Yeah, he's got Mooney in the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Darnell Mooney, as the first half is winding down. And the Bears are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. They'll look to throw. Oh, Fields is intercepted for a third time. Picked by Kevin Byard. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. 10, 5, and he takes it all the way back. It's a pick two, if you will, as that play backfires in a big way.
Well, there's some excitement, right? Go for two, and instead it gets picked off. And how about the return? Give him a lot of credit, though, for not giving up after the play.
Yeah, the troops rally.
Exactly, and getting back there and making the tackle and not giving up 2 points themselves.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fields this way up at the 17. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two.
And when you have success throwing the football, the old cliche becomes true. The playbook opens up wide, and these screen passes, they become even more difficult to stop.
Last play of the half, here's Willis. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far, and second down.
Well, there's times when you see these catches that are made, and we just know the guys playing it are really wishing for college rules. Only need that one foot down instead of two. It's awfully difficult on the sideline, isn't it?
Last play of the half, Willis. And now he'll let this one go deep, back over the middle. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. So two quarters down, two remain. Charles and I return after the break. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. Bullock out now to kick this one away. Offense ready to go for their next drive.
Well, Charles, in that first half, we saw a fair amount of offense on both sides of the football, and now the team trailing here will start with it in the third quarter.
And we both know this coach pretty darn well, don't we? Because his game planning is always on point. And now that he's getting the ball to start the second half, how about all the offense that you already referenced in the first half? He'll put that all together and come out with something really strong, I believe, to get things going here in the third quarter.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Fields. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
I'll give them credit for a good read right there because they read the man coverage on the right side and sent the tight end a few steps down the field and then angled him to the left on a crossing route. And he was able to get enough separation on this play to turn it into a nice gain.
So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. On first and 10, it's Herbert. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Play action. It's Fields. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Darnell Mooney, 43 yards. And the Bears have taken the lead here this third quarter.
And that third counter there gives them the lead, and it's obvious they've needed everything that he's given them today. The three touchdowns, that's impressive, but without them, they're not winning this game.
Santos with the extra point, and that gives him a three-point lead. The Bears send the kicking team out there, and they will send this one away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And Charles, it feels like we're set up for a good second half here. Came out of the locker room, one score game. Now the lead has already changed hands. Well, this offense, they've got an opportunity right now to take that lead right back.
Yeah, and it feels like you're going back and forth almost a little bit like a tennis match, right? And we're just there, you know, our heads just keep moving. Which side has it? Which side's going to score? How are they going to go out doing it? A little bit of a challenge for each side trying to match each other.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Second down, here's Willis. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Roquan Smith. And the Bears are going to take possession of the football. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning, threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now.
Right? Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Man open, here is Jones. Touchdown! Velus Jones, 30 yards. And the Bears take the interception on defense and convert it into 6 points. Santos able to tack on the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
Pass the 60, pass the 60.
From the 30 on second down, Willis throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. 7 yards there and a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to, pick up a first down.
Off the option, here's Henry. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45.
Sometimes with the running game, you just got to stick with it. Look, this is the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
With a rookie quarterback out there, you're definitely going to find out how he handles adversity, because this one so far hasn't gone according to plan. He's got to fight through it and show him what he's made of.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. 10th carry now for Derrick Henry. Yeah, Henry fighting for the marker, but I don't think he got there. He did not. The defense stiffens to force fourth down following that first down gain of 8.
I know they'd love to take some heat off of that young quarterback, but so far, not much in the running game, and this won't help things either. A loss on that play.
Going on fourth down, here's Willis. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he is going to pick up the Titans' first down as they manage to convert, and that'll keep the drive alive. So a moment to catch our collective breath after the fourth down conversion. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Come on up, I should have.
Let's go now. 18, fight here.
First and 10, it's Willis.
Oh.
This one hauled in again, it's Hooper. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 3. But correct me if I'm wrong, yeah, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. 15 yards down to the 15 and a first down.
Here we go, here we go.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Quick slant here to Woods. And it's a Titans touchdown. Robert Woods, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Titans have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
The line prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense.
Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
Under 4 to go now as the clock runs, and they come up on second down. Here's Fields. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. Only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, short tackle.
From the gun on third down, Fields. On the sideline, did he keep his feet in bounds? They say yes. Great job, both feet in, first down. A good pickup there, a 22.
Stop running that cover one.
So operating from Tennessee territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 47. A handoff for Herbert. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. Bud Dupree, a former first-round pick, in on the stop. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Bears with the football here as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. On second down, a run with Herbert. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. All eyes on Fields. And he won't get close. Only a yard, 4th and 3. The Titans going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
Like any team plan, they're looking for touchdowns to try and help their cause. But in this case, he does get them a little closer at least. If they make a field goal, it turns out to be the better call here.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This will get the lead up to 7. Santos' kick is up and through, and that'll make this a 7-point game. But from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a 1-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
Partner's a former defensive back. I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now, but let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Now Tennessee going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. Here's Willis.
And that's intercepted yet again, and that could be the backbreaker. Picked off by Roquan Smith, and the Bears have just about sewn up this football game.
Well, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make.
He's got a man complete. And he's across for the touchdown.
Expect teams to take a shot right after a turnover. You count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels, and that's exactly what they did there. They threw it downfield and really created a big play.
Yeah, you said jumbled. They were the definition of jumbled.
Got so many memories that I made on Cascade Road. I done gained the world. I ain't never.